Next up, we move to the C1 1,000 meters.
3 minutes to start.
The world record and the Olympic record.
1,000 meters.
Held and we will have by Spain's David Carl Figueroa.
Once again, changing now.
He doesn't go until the second heat.
2 minutes.
Position will be different. Born here, Vajda of Hungary is perhaps the man to watch, the Olympic champion.
Familiar with
K1, C1, K is kayak, C is canoe, and this is C1, this is canoe. This is the style and the technique. Obviously very, very different. It's very, very different demands on the body.
So these athletes don't have any rudders to steer the canoe, so it's all done with the blade
work. 1 minute. Please approach the starting blocks, gentlemen. 1 minute.
Good control, the good reach, and then they have to twist the paddle a little bit as they go down to keep the adjustment.
There is Attila Vajda, and he'll also compete in the newly introduced C1 200 meter event, the sprint. Mathieu Gobel of France, 32-year-old from Boulogne.
Please approach the starting line, gentlemen. Bring your boats down to the line.
Jake Donaghy, 17-year-old from Brisbane. We'll go with friend Alex Haas in the C2 1000. Still have great hopes for him for the future, perhaps. This Olympic Games might come just a little bit too early, but he's a very, very powerful youngster. So we didn't see there, Ilya Stokov.
1, 2, 7. Please approach the line, gentlemen. 1, 2, 7, approach the line.
Play of Senegal.
And as they line themselves up in the buckets, they'll really try and get their boat angle so it's facing towards their paddle, the little paddles that they're actually leaning on, so that they can get away without having to do any steering strokes for the first couple of strokes.
You see the angle of Goubel, France.
Ready, set.
Vajda, Hungary, pointing slightly to the left as he paddles on that side.
France gets away nicely. Long reach, the full of the paddle which drives that blade into the water. It's got a good jump out the start here and set a nice rhythm.
First and last.
Looking for a firm entry as they drive that blade into the water. Blade angles about 60 degrees so that they can get the power on, and they have to twist it to actually get the bow running as smoothly as they can. But today is great conditions for them, there's no crosswind. So it provides a good opportunity to drive as much forward as possible.
Goubel takes it out through 250 metres. Gold medals in the European Championships. C1 500 this year. Silver in the 1000. Ralph Williams of Samoa finding power craft. Goubel at the upper end of the field, surging on.
Just like in the kayaks, they actually look to have the connection from the blade through their arms and through their bodies all the way down into the boat, sort of connected through their feet, their back, through their knees. They're kneeling up in the boat using incredible core strength.
Wonderful view from on high as well, from the wire cam. The Olympic champion comes through in second at the halfway mark. Ilya Stokolov and Jake Donaghy. Around the hill, as it was in the K1 1000 meters. First five to go through, plus the one fastest loser from all the heats.
Again, it's the left-handed power. We don't always see the athletes compete to paddling on the same side, which makes you a good condition for the wind. But out here today is a pretty even playing field with the wind just behind them. It's a great view, just how hard they drive that body, fall onto that blade and push the paddle through the water.
It's a fairly limber hip flexors to do this event. Attila Vider in second place at the moment, pushing up on Kubel. Winning comes through. He's actually had quite a quiet start to 2012 for his team. He's finished six in the last two World Cup outings, but he's somebody who really does thrive on the big stage. But Kubel taking them through to the final quarter of the race. The noise goes from the stand as they come past now. And these two setting themselves clearly for the take. Ilya Stokolov now. It's Gubel who has led just about from the start, taking him towards the finish in Vida. And they're happy to settle for second place in this game. Both of them easing down slightly now. See the distance between them and Stokolov in third place, and a long way from Stokolov to the man in fourth at the moment, who is Jake Donoghue. These three and the next two to go through. Jake Donoghue is going to get there as well. But Gubel the winner. And looking in good shape. So there is Jake Donoghue, the Queenslander, the youngster. Through to the semi-final, might find it hard there, and the fifth man to go through automatically from here is in Diatte, way of Senegal. And as Gubel just paddles gently to disembark, Rudolf Williams of Samoa still going, and up to the line now. Is in the semi-finals where things will get far more competitive, obviously, but Rudolf Williams has looked like he's enjoyed himself, but I'm sure he has. Hard, hard work. The magic of Gubel, different class throughout. Great view from on high, what it takes. And I see one.
See the body just shifting, it bends over that front leg as they drive that top arm and push the paddle. They almost fall on the paddle as it enters the water and then get that catch to pull the water by them and get that boat really shifting forward.
Confirmation of a fairly clear cut event, but Gubel and Vida really setting themselves apart, but also through Stokolov, Jake Donoghue and Yat Gway. So to heat two, and names to look out for: David Carl of Spain, Mark Aldershaw as well, Canadian, very, very impressive paddler, and Sebastian Brendel of Germany, 24-year-old police officer from Schwedt-Oder, up in the order in the northeast of the country, first Olympics. Jose Cristobal of Mexico. Now there is Mark Aldershaw. His grandfather Bert competed in the London Games in 1948 and 52 and 56 as well. David Kahl, a medal for him would make him Spain's most successful Olympian of all time.
1 minute to start.
Initially failed to qualify for these games, later included as a replacement for the injured Pavel Bareskovic. And Fortunato Passavira of Angola makes up this field. Just six going here, so only one will drop out automatically. Five to go through. And the best, fastest loser.
Just guide themselves into the start buckets. They don't want to be there too early because it's quite difficult to actually keep the stability in these canoes once they're in the buckets.
What a pleasant day down in Dorney at the moment. The sun is shining. get ready for the second heat in the men's. C1, 1,000 meters, 5 to go through automatically.
Set.
There's 6 going here, so just thinning out the field slightly. Slightly start from Peter Coletta, Poland.
Not sure, gets away nicely there. Paddling on the right hand side, so really getting the reach, getting the drive through that upper arm as he pushes the paddle into the water.
And it's he and Sebastian Brendel of Germany who take it out. Dynasty, which grandfather Bert competing here in the 200 Olympics. His uncle's competing in 72 and 76. He's coached by his father Scott, who paddled for Canada in 84 in Los Angeles.
Brendel suffered such disappointment last year at the World Championships when he snapped his paddling. He dominated the Europeans prior to that, so he was such a disappointment. He's more likely to see him on the outside lane.
He won the World Cup of 18 years ago. May, and he takes that. He has to be great to have a 50 meter mark. Silver behind the Tilla Fida in Beijing. Blue now on Oldershaw. So Oldershaw, Cal Figueroa, Brendel and Cristobal, first four at the moment.
He's been picked up as well now, gets himself into the lead.
Coletta comes through to take the fifth automatic spot. And a long way behind, I'm afraid we can see Fortunato Pasadena, but David Cal Figueroa is the winner. I can safely say that he's not going to be the one fastest in automatic qualifier. But approaching the finish line now. Adari Carl Figueroa, great Olympian in this event, not a steady start, but no more than that, and then gradually moved his way through.
Power that gets driven down as they just push that top hand heavily into the water. And in the later stage of this competition, when we get to the semi-finals final, we might even see them, what they call, like, jump their boats over the finish line, just see if they can just nip ahead of their competitors.
Confirmation then of the results. Five to go through automatically. Promising a particular drama in the first round heats, because it's just about seeing how people are, what stage they're at with the fitness and the preparations, and certainly all favourites so far in the K1 and the C1 look to be in good form. It's just about seconds and a little bit of a chaff in the weeks, the opening rounds. The semi-finals will get a little bit more interesting.
It's quite unusual that
2 minutes to start. 2 minutes. Please approach the start line. 2 minutes. Please approach the start line.
Now, I find it fairly straightforward to pick the five who'll go through here in this third heat. Only five competing. There is Richard Jeffries. And you know, while a very strong, still a youngster, and still fairly new to the event as well, Alexander Diakuk. Kazakhstan alongside him. Here's Alexander Zhukovsky of Belarus. Bronze medalist in the European Championships this year in this event. Vadim Menkov of Uzbekistan, fourth in Beijing. His form over the past 18 months suggests that a medal is a real possibility as well. Josef Chirila. World champion in the C4.
1 minute to start. 1 minute.
1,000. But again, just five in this heat. So I know that this man, Richard Jeffries, will go through. I'm sure he wants to go through. But does he want to be in this event?
Well, he'll be using it as a warm-up for the latter stages of this competition. Oh, sorry, the latter stages of the week, where he'll be competing in the 200 metres, which is actually his preferred distance, his chosen distance that he trains for. So he could find 1,000 metres quite tough. But I'm sure he'll give it his all. He said that prior to his racing, he'll be out there and obviously enjoying the atmosphere, soaking up the environment, ready for later on when he competes in 200.
Just to explain, as host nation, Great Britain had a place in this and had to fill it. So Richard Jeffries is there, but his preferred distance is the 200 metres. He will go through here. All these five will go through to the semi-finals later on today. And I think Rio, when he brought into this sport, that was always going to be his target in 4 years' time. So even though it's his goal, it's a little bit too soon. Easier now after that initial search for Alexander Diakuk and Alexander Zhukovsky as well. Going along nicely.
1,000 metres really an event where we can see quite a change in the leaders throughout it, compared to what we'll see later on when we find the leaders in the 200 metres.
From Great Britain after then, too. He's in the halfway, training
nothing, but only been handling since 2007. And it's not really a thousand meter handler. His main forte is a 200 meter. Really a car.
You've got to tell what priorities are here to race, or really to conserve energy, knowing that they're going through.
Almost like a warm-up for them. It certainly doesn't look as much effort going in as we have seen in the previous heat.
At the moment, Vadim Menkov from Uzbekistan is out in front. He was just outside the medals in Beijing 4 years ago. Won the World Championships last year. World Cup campaign this year. Soon as the World Cup ends. Richard Jeffries coming through now, just ahead of Alexander Djavchuk. With each other in the final 100, 200, well, throughout the race really, but just seeing what they've got. Feeling each other out as well. Technology out there and then just testing the changes in speed.
Gave us a flavour of what we're going to see later on in the semi-finals when the racing really heats up. So unlike the kayaks, the canoes are a very open cockpit. And the competitors have what they foam knee box that they put in the bottom of the boat where they fix their knees that they have at the back into the boat.